What's going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to break down for you why Notion is good, but ClickUp is also good. Before we get into the actual nitty gritty and into the software, I will say the pricing structure of ClickUp is interesting. There is a little less in regards to the free aspect, in my personal opinion. There is an unlimited amount of like tag usage and stuff like that in Notion. You can tag anything you want. However, ClickUp does this weird thing where like you can't label more than like 150 or 100 things. And I don't really know if that's great for productivity and task management. Like obviously you can pay for the pro version for a very low price, just as you can with Notion. However, the free version of Notion, in my opinion, is a little bit better. But ClickUp does have some things, even in their free version, as we'll see in this video, that are better than Notion. Now, without further ado, let's get into the software.
All right, ladies and gents, here it is, the day that I finally review something that's not Notion. So in this video, we're going to break things down a little bit differently. First and foremost, we're going to go into task management. So I have all a bunch of different tasks here that were partially auto-created, and I'll give them credit for that, but it's a nice little setup to have going forward. So first and foremost, just with basic task management and the different things you can do in here, I opened up a task and there's a lot of different options that actually aren't included in Notion that are really nice. You can track the amount of time you have, so you can, you know, time how much it took to do a task, which really helps for planning. You can set a little estimate to see how long you think it'll take in the future if you make a similar task. There are obviously templates, just like within Notion. There's duplicating tasks, and then when you do that, actually, interestingly enough, you can choose what to duplicate. You can duplicate everything, just the due date, everything but the assigned comments, activity. There's a lot of different aspects here that honestly Notion doesn't have the exact same capabilities as. It's really extensive. There's a template center that can work here. You can go into a task and save it as a template rather than like having to make a template, then copy and paste it like you do in Notion. Or you can browse through different templates as you have something opened, and it can actually, there's a lot of different templates, just like Notion has for different pages and stuff and different views, which is really nice. But anyways, let's go within the actual task. You can do a slash toggle like usual. Example here, let's do it just a slash command and see what we got. So we have checklists, dividers, bulleted lists, tables, code block, all pretty standard stuff when in comparison to Notion. Nothing crazy extensive or different. A bunch of different background colors, embeds, cloud apps, YouTube. It's got maybe different functionality than Notion, but you know, there are very similar things overall. So it's not like it's gonna be anything crazy different within this area. So I don't want to get too into that. There's like the tags area you can have. Here are the different fields that you can put in there. So I'd say more than Notion. Maybe not. I'm not actually sure. I think it's a similar number. So we got date, drop down, labels, all very fine. Progress, that's actually something that's not within Notion. Checkbox, yep. Normal text area, so like longer text, email, files. All this stuff is pretty standard over here. I don't actually think Notion has money. People is obviously there. Progress is something that Notion doesn't have. You have to like create something for it. You can link it to other tasks, just like relational databases in Notion. And then that's pretty much all the fields you got here. So let's show a progress one. That's kind of interesting. Oh, it already had one there. Well, so if we make a subtask, example subtask, this is also something that's nice and already in there. So task two, if you press this and say it's complete, the subtask, it'll show you how far along it is, which I think is nice. I think sometimes in Notion you get lost in the fact that you can't do something like that. There are different checklists that you can add that are nice that are outside of this main text area. So it kind of separates maybe some content sort of situation from subtasks or checklists that always need to be there. You can make templates for checklists and put that in within different tasks, which is really nice as well. And then what is really cool is I'll go to a different view here. Let's go to a calendar view. All right, so if we go to a calendar view, you can actually set recurring tasks. So I have an example one here, so we can do recurring tasks, which is not an option in Notion. It's just not, which is unfortunate. So we go to like the due date, we can set recurring, and it'll recur forever. It'll recur at a certain time, whether weekly, daily, monthly, when it's closed, when it's done, or on a specific time. So let's say when it's done, let's do recur forever. Save here. So if I do this and complete it, it'll recur to the next week. We go to the next week here. It's really nice. Like, you can't do that in Notion. That's just something you can't do. And ClickUp has a lot of different functionality that, you know, it makes me think, could that be something I use in the future? Possibly. Do I think it's as aesthetically pleasing as Notion? No, but if I had a team or something, I'd consider it. I just think Notion gives me less friction because I like the vibe. There's another little thing I want to call out here. It shows you all the different activity you can have. It shows that it was duplicated, and that's really nice. It shows you things that you don't need necessarily, but it's good to keep track of if you have a business. All right, so let's show you the different list views you can have. So there's a lot of different ones here. It's just your basic list here. You can break things down into different categories, sure, but there's a board view, which is very, very usual, like in Notion. There's a workload one where you can, if you had a pro version, you can see how much of a workload you have. Obviously calendar, as I showed earlier. I want to showcase more, actually. So let's go to different things here. There's activity. It shows, you know, what changed. I did a bunch of activity just now, and it gives you the activity that's happened. Workload kind of shows you where you're at on a certain day of the week as to what your workload is. There's timeline views for when stuff is due. That's in Notion as well. There's obviously calendar view. Let's show you any other views that are possible. There's a map where it's your place to visualize all your tasks that are tied to an address location. It's actually kind of cool. There's obviously table views that are pretty standard, just like within Notion. You just add all the different functionality here. It's interesting though, because when you do something like this, you by default have none of the different aspects of these set up, and then you have to show the fields or use or create a new field as you're doing this. Very interesting way that they do tables. I think Notion has something similar, but I don't know if it always defaults to zero. If I'm blanking on that, that's on me. There's a Gantt timeline, which is great for projects. People really like this one for a lot of different reasons. It showcases a different timeline view. I think that normal list stuff is fine. You can actually have like page views of documents, embeds, or forms, which are really nice within ClickUp as well. This actually requires a pro plan, but it's nice. You can have a team situation and have a form set up on a specific list view. So basically this whole folder has what's called lists within it. Like these three different things are lists. And then for some reason, there's also like the list view. And then there are different breakouts of that. So this is just task views, list view. And so for example, if you want to make another list, it tells you to make another list, which just be example. And this is like then something that can be broken down into different views. Don't know why it's exactly called list if that's also a sub situation, but we make do. So this is a really nice view here. You can see exactly what your different tasks are for the day. So I didn't spell right, which is kind of lame, but we got something very interesting. So you can have a different due date time in here. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So let's say it's like 8:45 when it's due. If you have stuff that's due in this default home view in ClickUp, you have some really nice functionality. So I can just have my daily planner sort of situation and see exactly when things are due. This is nice. Like this is very good. I have my daily planner in Notion, which kind of populates everything, but this is by default. This shows you a lot of different things. What's not scheduled, what's up next, what's overdue, what's been delegated, what's done. It's really nice. Like this is not something that you usually are going to have in a sort of software like this, or at least in comparison to Notion. It's not something that's, I think it's something that's very unique. I think it's something that's very unique and Notion doesn't have it, and I wish it did. I mean, granted, I made one for myself, but this is impressive. I'm happy to see that a software takes the steps out for somebody to create a nice view for themselves by default and have it as a home view. So we can go to documents real quick just to break this down. So here's an example of what a document's like. Pretty standard stuff, similar to a page in Notion. I think that it's nice that they have different options here for text backgrounds, all that sort of stuff, coding things in, quotes, checklists you can make. It's pretty standard, but I just gave an example of the Rise Project podcast and some of the video ideas podcast ideas that we have. And, you know, you can add icons and all the usual stuff, just like you can within Notion. So very standard. You can share the pages, add comments, make it full width or not, add a page inside of it. Very standard stuff. Now, something that's very different that ClickUp has that's very much team-based that Notion does not have is dashboards. So I've created an example dashboard here where you can see the workload that's done by status, different reports on what's been completed. You can obviously filter this out by different people, and that's really nice. So for example, if you have a team, you can kind of keep a dashboard going of who on the team is, you know, good workload-wise, who is getting their work done. And this is if you have a point system as a company, really nice. Really nice to be able to say, okay, this person's like actually grinding stuff out, whereas somebody else maybe is a little bit slacking, or they have a sprint that they have to do. There's sprints in here for the different team plans that you can have. And then also just in general, say you want to get a lot of work done at your company, you know, this is a way to keep workloads tracked. And if you assign the right amount of hours and points to things, you can, not saying micromanage your employees, but it's a good thing. This is something where you can very much find something that's impressive in the sense that you're seeing some serious optimization of the time that you have with the people that you work with. So overall, this is pretty good. I can't complain. I think that was a very bare bones overview of what ClickUp is, but I just kind of wanted to give you an idea of all the different aspects that this software has, because, well, it's extensive. So I will get more into specific aspects of it in a later video.